Studios, Transmission TV presents Live on Tuesday, hosted by Kozak DeMar. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Transmission TV. With Tuesday Night Live, I'm Kozak Damaris, and I'm absolutely delighted to be here tonight to be hosting the show once again. It's our 13th episode, I'll singularize that. Unlucky for some. Josh said it was a lucky number. I don't know, he's our new camera tech for the day today. So we're gonna find out today how many fuck-ups we do maybe, and we'll find out if it's actually an unlucky number. But today's show is gonna be absolutely fantastic, guys. It is the first time we're actually bringing on a guest that is not a musician, which is absolutely amazing. We have the wonderful actor, director, and writer, Adam William Cahill, joining us as our first guest. We're gonna be talking about his latest debut featured film called Follow the Dead. Super excited to get to know about the Irish film industry as well. An industry that's very untapped from us at Transmission TV. So super duper excited to be getting involved with that conversation with him. We've also got an amazing singer-songwriter, KK Lewis, joining us as well today. We did a pre-record for her a couple of weeks ago here in Tsunami Studios. It sounds absolutely fantastic. And we're gonna have a bit of a chat about her life, her busking in Berlin. She released a fantastic EP called Dreaming as well. So we're gonna have a bit of a chat about that as well. So you're all very, very welcome, guys, to today's show. Please pop a comment in and say hello. Let us know you're there. And of course, we're going to have a bit of a Q&A with our guests as well, and a bit of a fun interactive segment as well, where you guys can get involved. So really excited about that. So we got Keto in the house as technical producer. Keto, what's the crack? How are you?
How are you getting on, Kozak?
Grand, like, yeah. I think the intro was all right, wasn't it? I didn't feck it up too much there.
No, yeah, it was fine. Yeah,
a couple of words.
Getting better at it every day.
Getting a little bit better. Yeah, getting the energy and stuff like that. It's getting a bit colder, isn't it, man? It's freezing. I got my jacket on today.
Yeah, well, you're keeping that on you because the microphone's on it.
It is. Yeah, we're stuck with it now for the rest of the show, pretty much. But yeah, no, really excited because we're coming up to Halloween now, and we're in Ballyferma.
Yeah.
It's going to get pretty rowdy over here, isn't it, soon?
Yeah, yeah, you're going to hear fireworks everywhere.
Bonfires, the place is going to be set on fire, maybe. You don't know what's going to happen.
No, Jesus Christ. Did you hear this, lad?
Can you cut that out? We're not live. But no, really excited because we have an upcoming Halloween episode as well, coming up on the 26th. And we're going to be giving away some prizes for that as well. So keep that in mind. We're live every 2 weeks here in the studio. So look, without further ado, let me pop around to my desk. I'm going to introduce our first guest today. Very excited about this one. So we got loads of yous in the comments section. Jesus, guys. We got Ziggy Stardust from us. We got Archie in the comment section there. I'm going a bit blurry there. There we go. I'm back in screen there. Okay, we lost a bit of visuals there. We got Dave Duggan in the house. We got Lucid Dreaming for Egypt. Fantastic name, love that name. We got John Howell. What's the story, John? And yeah, keep those comments going, guys. I'm gonna introduce our first guest. Yes. We've got actor, writer, producer, editor, and director based in Dublin. He directed his first short film in 2017 called Inertia. He was a body double for Samuel Barnett on the TV show Penny Dreadful, and recently wrote and directed his first feature film called Follow the Dead. We're going to play a couple of clips from that film as well, guys, and we're going to find out how we can watch it and things like that. In between all of this, he has studied all aspects of film and has networked his way through the fascinating film industry here in Ireland. Please welcome our first guest, Adam William Cahill. Welcome to the show. How are you doing? Good to see you.
It's been a while.
It has been a while. 2018.
Yes.
Yeah. 3 years.
Although at this stage, that doesn't feel that long ago considering how fast the last 2 years have gone.
It's mad how they flew, right?
Yeah,
it's crazy.
It's insane.
So we did something together. I did a casting call for extras for Rockstar Karaoke. So some people might know that project. And you came up and performed an absolute stormer of Let Me Entertain You on stage at Grand Social.
That was the song of choice for everybody, right? That
everybody sang it.
Everybody sang it.
So we had a great gauge of how everybody did. And you're a fantastic singer, I have to say.
Thank you. I appreciate that. Yeah. I don't think I made it into the final cut of the ad somehow, though. I don't remember seeing myself, did I?
Yeah, Jesus. No, I'll have to resend that to you. No, you're definitely in it. I remember you in it because we definitely had to select that because it was, we had such a variety of different singers, which was great. That was the idea it. So we had so many people in. But no, you did make it. You mustn't have watched it, the full feature. You're probably just like, yeah.
I'm sure I'm in there somewhere.
I'm sure I'm in there somewhere. Yeah, I'll just put my name on it and then just put it on my demo reel.
No, it was a seriously eclectic group. Like the all ages, people who like rock music, pop music, like a bit of everything in there. Yeah. And everyone did their own stint on it. So it was really, really good.
Yeah. Do you find that as well when casting for extras? Do you get a variety of different... people that come to those castings?
It depends on what you're looking for. If you put out a call for a very specific, you know, demographic, then that's what's going to turn up. And then, but if it's just an open one, then yeah, you do. You tend to get a kind of a wide range. We were very fortunate when we did the extras casting for Father of the Dead. We needed because the scene involved was like a town hall scene. It needed to be, you know, old people, young people, men, women,
mixture of everything,
and we did. That's what we got. So we were very fortunate in that sense. Yeah.
How does it work? Like, you wear a variety of hats when doing well over the course of your film career, really, right? Yeah. Now you mentioned that you're not doing acting as much now, as more so directing.
Yeah.
How did that kind of transition? What was that kind of transition for you then, where you said, okay, I'm going to focus more on directing now and writing? What was that kind of for you?
I think probably like a lot of people, when they first fall in love with filmmaking in general, if you get any notions whatsoever of wanting to be part of that community and part of that industry, your first thought runs to acting. Yeah. And so that's what it was for me. And then I went and decided that I know it's a really difficult industry to break into, no matter where you are in the world. Mm-hmm. And what I decided to do was I wanted to go and study film production so that I could make my own films and then cast myself in them. Brilliant. But then while I was in college, in my final year project where I had to write and direct and produce a short film, by the time that I saw the actors that I had cast perform what I had written, I just fell in love with the process of making it from behind the scenes. I loved that these guys were putting their heart and soul into words that didn't exist until I put them on paper. And then we built the set from scratch for the film. Oh. Everything came together to make something that, you know, I felt like more than acting. Like, there's no way acting could possibly make me, just who I am, feel as fulfilled as being behind the scenes, pulling all the strings, to be honest. Yeah. So I enjoy acting. I'm not saying I'll never do it again, but it's certainly something that's taken a massive backseat for me because I just love writing my own stuff and producing my own stuff.
That's great. And I mean, that first short film was in 2017. Is it Inertia?
Yeah, 2016, I think, is that when that came out. Inertia, yeah, you're
2016,
right.
2016, so that was Tig Devery and Mary Beth Heron.
Absolutely,
as well, right?
Who also made it into Father of the Dead because we kept a very close relationship and
fantastic.
They're tremendous actors. So
yeah, fantastic. And what is like the scene like? I mean, is it difficult to kind of bring people together for a shooting? Like, how is the process for you? Like, I mean, the producer, I guess, takes care of a lot of the kind of nitty gritty organizing. Do you produce as well?
You have to. I mean, look, when you say that I wear all hats, it's not necessarily just because I'm a control freak, which I am, but like, and I want to kind of be involved in every single aspect of making my stuff. But it's also because when you're starting out, there's no budget, which means that you can't afford to pay a producer, pay a director, or pay a writer, whatever. So I have to do all of those things.
Yeah.
But I love it. So I will always work that way, to be honest. I mean, some of the kind of smaller jobs that I would do as well, I'd probably, if the budget got bigger, I would start getting other people involved. But I'm very, very happy to do an awful lot of it myself. I love the business.
Yeah.
And then, you know, like there's even though Ireland is a very small country, you'd be surprised the amount of talent out there and the amount of people out there who are so eager to get into the industry. I don't find it very difficult at all. If I'm looking for any kind of crew member or any cast member, there's plenty of people out there to choose from. It's a rich industry, in spite of the fact that it's such a small country.
Yeah, that's really interesting, because you would think that it might be a bit tricky to kind of typecast somebody, but I guess there's so much variety in Ireland, isn't it? Dublin has become such a melting pot as well of so many different nations. So it's, but you can kind of find almost everybody that you might need, you know, for a film, which is fantastic. But yeah, doing the producer work as well as then directing and writing is a is a massive task. And you finished college only last year and you just went straight into a film, right? So you went straight into writing. And
as soon as I finished, it was 2 years ago. I immediately was like, well, actually, I was inspired because Lou Corcoran, who plays the lead in Follow the Dead, came to me with a short film script, which was the kernel of what Follow the Dead ended up being. So it was a short film called Crack of the Dead that he dreamt up one night, and he just kind of had this funny, anything that he writes, he's a writer as well, and anything that he writes it's laced with comedy. It's always the direction that he goes with his stuff, and I just found it really amusing. So we decided to, I definitely want to get involved in this. So we started trying to get it off the ground. Unfortunately, because we had a few location issues at the time, it ended up getting put on the long finger. But because I was enamored with the idea of our generation dealing with the zombie apocalypse, how would we deal with it? Because we've seen what Romero thought of his generation, you know, so many times. Mm. We've seen, I would say Shaun of the Dead is probably the Gen Xers as opposed to millennials. So yeah. For me, it was like, what would millennials do in a zombie apocalypse? And what would Irish millennials do in a zombie apocalypse? And the more that was milling over in my mind, I thought there's so many possibilities with this. And I ended up coming back to him and I said, look, man, I've got a 100-page script that's kind of loosely based on the characters that he had originally came up with.
Yeah.
And he was just delighted that now it was a feature. And, you know,
fantastic.
That's how we how it took off after that. It was just, it kind of had a life of its own.
Yeah.
It sounds cliche, but it really did.
Yeah, I guess a lot of cliches kind of are factual almost in a way, isn't it? So you had the ball rolling and then it almost just kind of grew and grew as you went along. You took out a bank loan as well, I read in your IMDb, to kind of fund everything.
Yeah.
How is it like, for example, like submitting the film then, like, you know, to festivals? Is that a process in itself? Do you need to register? How does that kind of work? Because I have no idea how it sort of works.
Submitting to festivals?
Yeah, stuff like that. And maybe do you need to register with unions and things like that? Is that all part of the process?
No. Like, it depends on it's mostly done through specific websites. You've got Film Freeway and you've got there's another one, Something Fest. I never used that one, so I can't remember. But Film Freeway mainly. So you set up your company. So for me, obviously Wild Stag Productions.
Yeah.
And then you would create your project. So I have Inertia, Follow the Dead, Loose Thread on there.
Yeah.
And whenever I can search then all the different festivals that are available, and I will submit to the ones that I think are the ones that are most apt for whatever project that I'm trying to send it on to. And there's it's really not difficult once you have proof that your work is copyrighted. It's all your own stuff. You're not using anybody else's material. The festivals don't look into it then too much more than that. They're just like, okay, if you're saying that's okay, you've signed the contract basically online, I agree to this, then, you know, there's no, they don't have to be concerned about the implications. So I know that all of my stuff is my own work. It's not plagiarized.
Yeah.
And it's a very, very easy process.
That's great. And then, so you set up Stag Productions then to sort of submit them to festivals and things like that.
Yeah.
And when did you set that up pretty much when you started Follow the Dead, or was it before?
So I set up Wild Stag Productions as a business name first. I was just kind of trading under Wild Stag Productions, but I think it was within the last 12 months, I'm pretty sure. It's now a limited company.
Right.
So I just wanted to make sure that everything was on the up and up, when, especially now that things are kind of getting a bit more serious, where I am looking, I don't think I would ever be able to fund another feature myself, because I crippled myself for a few years.
There's only so many bank loans you can take out, right?
Exactly, there really is. I mean, like, you when you're starting out, you definitely need to invest in yourself.
Yeah.
Nobody else will. No one believes in you more than you do.
100%,
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So you really got to back yourself, back the people who are on your team, who you trust. But at this stage now, I'm like, okay, I'm going to be going to investors for future films. And so having a limited company and having everything official.
Yeah.
Is going to make things so
obviously
much easier
that's
for
going
me.
To assist. And you've got some great movies under your belt now as well, so you can sort of present that. So we have a scene from Follow the Dead, and Keith, are you going to put that up for us?
If you ask nicely, maybe.
All right, please, Jesus. Heck's sake.
No, I will. I'll get it up for you there now, guys. Go on.
He's just stalling now because he doesn't have it lined up. He's like, I forgot that I was supposed to do that.
Popping up online. Dublin's in shambles. People are killing each other. Everything's gone. Shite. And dude, it's fucking zombies. Jay? I don't want to hear any more of this shit.
You mean you know about it? What are we gonna do?
Nothing, man. It's fake news.
But there's nothing coming out of Dublin at all about it.
And there's nothing anything. Do you know what I want to know?
What?
How many times will I have to tell you not to leave the door open before you close the bleeding thing, huh? Cover that story for me, will you?
Oh, but man, I've been researching this for hours and I'm telling you, it's the apocalypse!
There's no such thing as zombies, Jay.
Just get the cans.
Brilliant. And that's Lou Corcoran, of course, on the left-hand side there. So what was kind of like your inspiration, I guess, about even that scene in itself? Like, did it come out of nowhere? Or tell us a little bit about that.
What I really wanted to focus on, like, in terms of Luke's character, obviously, because the initial idea was his, he was always going to play the protagonist, Robbie, who, in typical millennial fashion, it believes everything is fake news. He's not really interested in all of the only reason that they find out that an apocalypse has taken place in Dublin via social media, you know? So yeah. All of the news that they're getting is viral videos.
Yeah.
So Robbie's instant reaction is, this is ridiculous. He's the cynic. Whereas obviously his cousin Jay, played by Luke Collins, he is insisting, no, this is real, this is legit, trust me. He's watched a few too many zombie films. And then Jay's brother, played by Tyke Devery, the Chi, comes out of the bathroom taking the mic. So yeah. They all, the family, there's four of them as well. Luke's character Robbie has a sister, Liv, played by Mary Beth Heron. Mm-hmm. And the four of them kind of have this... almost distaste towards one another at times. They rub each other the wrong way, which is obviously where the comedy comes from. But it's all they all represent something different in terms of how I believe millennials would react in that environment. Right. And I wanted to make sure that where they are in that scene, they're in their home in Offaly, you know, so they're miles away from all the action taking place in Dublin.
Right.
So they have no idea what's going on, and I wanted them to basically be, you know. They're not taking things seriously enough until it gets too late. And I genuinely believe that in this day and age, and I don't mind commenting on millennials because I am a millennial, right?
Sure.
I think that most of us would probably assume that the government's going to do something about it. So, yeah. You know, someone else out there with authority is going to deal with the problem. We don't have to do anything because at this stage, I think that we've been very comfortable, pampered maybe.
Sure,
so,
sure.
I think that's probably the way it go down. So, and then the comedy is comes from there squabbling up until the proverbial hits the fan.
Awesome. Yeah, I haven't seen the full film yet, so I'm really looking forward to watching it. Like, where can people watch it? Is it available
at the moment? It's still on the festival circuit, and it probably will be. It will be right through the way through 2022 as well. But it doesn't prevent me from being able to release it on VOD.
Okay.
So we are in contact with an American streaming service at the moment, and they are currently procuring the funding to be able to buy the film. And
fantastic.
Then once they do, then it'll be available on there.
That's exciting stuff, man. That's extremely exciting.
Yeah, like I'm blessed by God that this is kind of coming to my lap, because it's not every filmmaker who kind of will get an offer like that, to be honest, you know, it's it was very fortuitous, and I'm, hopefully it's the start of something, a relationship with them that will lead to more films getting made. And for me, I am obsessed with the idea of making authentically Irish genre films.
Yeah.
I really want, I the most important thing for me when I'm thinking of making a movie is that it's high concept. I don't really like making films that have, that, you know, when you explain it to someone, they don't really kind of get what it is. If I turn to someone and I say it's millennials versus zombies, you kind of have an idea of what it is immediately.
Absolutely. You can explain that in half a sentence, right? So that's perfect. It's real to you, it's relatable, and you're tying in something, like you're putting in a, what do you call it, like a conflict into a basic situation that's obviously with just Irish people and their different reactions to it, which is fantastic.
I think having an Irish voice for all of those situations would, like, if I was able to make an Irish Western, an Irish Goonies, you know what I mean?
Are people doing that at the moment? Like something similar? Is there any directors or writers that are kind of similar to?
I haven't seen too many Irish genre films, to be honest. Most of the stuff, I mean, again, when you're like, genre films can be very expensive to make as well.
Okay.
So I think for the most part, when people are doing they're making their first film, it's normally a drama because you just need to ask someone, can you get loan of their house for a couple of weeks? And yeah, you know,
it's a bit easier on the production side of things.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah. Zombies wasn't too bad because it's literally it's makeup and it's prosthetics and whatever. It's not, you know, wasn't the worst thing in the world.
So we're gonna see some zombies in this.
Oh yeah, 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 for sure. It does.
Does it get gruesome? How gruesome?
Well, do you know what? I read someone commented, someone tweeted about the film after watching it, I think in Indie Cork, which we just screened in last week. Mm-hmm. And they referred to it as having the right amount of humor and gore and scares. So I was like, okay, that's great. That's good to know.
You've got the balance going anyway.
Yeah. And I didn't think of it as particularly gory myself, but it is. It's definitely violent.
Yeah, yeah. You're probably used to it now. You're probably just
I was editing. I've seen the film about 3 million times, editing it over and over again. So yeah.
That's amazing. So you edited it as well, were you just doing all the editing?
Yeah. Wow. This is the thing. Like, you kind of, you know, I can't afford to hire somebody else to do it at that stage. Even now, I'm still, you know, I need to get funding for the future projects, and then maybe I'll hand off some of the jobs. But I think, as far as like when you want to be an auteur, which is what I'm attempting to be, then writing it, directing it, and editing it means that from start to finish, it's my vision, and I will take all the heat then. Yeah. If people think it's good or bad, whatever, it's on me.
Yeah.
And then. Well, I mean, if it's good, obviously it's down to the performances and the tech guys involved as well. But if it's bad, I'll just take the blame.
yeah, of course, you'll take it's the risk. Fault. But it looks fantastic. I'm really looking forward to seeing the whole thing. I think we have another clip up as well, so we'll give people another bit of a teaser.
Absolutely.
So, Keto, if you have that ready, or do you want to stall for a little bit? It's up to you, man. What do you think?
I take it you're doing quite well.
What?
Well, whatever this is, must be keeping you quite busy. I'll be speaking to Sergeant Whelan before too long, I imagine.
We have been busy, actually. Haven't even had a chance to drop your date home yet.
Evening, all. Lovely weather, wouldn't you say?
Where are you off to?
Mrs. Mooney down the way said the dogs have to give her an awful doing. Nearly took a chunk out of her leg, apparently. So she stuck the thing with a knife. Now she wants someone to clean up the mess. She's in terrible shock.
Did you call an ambulance?
No, officer. I thought I'd let her bleed to death. And see if she comes back from the dead.
Tomorrow at 12. Make sure you attend, all right?
Sure, I could drop by. Gotta have each other's backs, right?
Fantastic. Always reminds me like of Irish Seth Rogen or something in that
really?
Intro with the smoke or whatever he had there.
Yeah, yeah.
Really fantastic. I really am looking forward to it. Is there anything else that so you actually won 6 awards for this already as well?
7.
So
we won Fright Night just recently.
Oh, congratulations. Yeah. So how many how many festivals did you apply for? How many?
That's the kind of the sneaky secret. I mean, people don't see how many rejections you get. So there is a significant number of festivals that when we first set out. I'm very happy to report that the very first festival we submitted to was Kerry International Film Festival, which we got into and then won. So that one will it was their first feature. We won Best Narrative at it, and it's an Irish festival. So that will always be the one that's closest to our heart.
Yeah.
After that, there were a number of higher up festivals that didn't seem keen. It doesn't always necessarily mean they didn't like the film. It could just be that it didn't really fit in with what they had. Most festivals tend to go with a theme based on their submissions.
Sure.
So I kind of keep my chin up by kind of thinking along those lines
But I mean, it's worldwide where you can submit these, right?
So yeah, absolutely.
It's absolutely global. So there's so many options. So did you film at all during the pandemic, or was that already kind of finished by pandemic? It was just released during pandemic, right?
Yeah, then? It was released.
Or you finished up with it, yeah.
First screening was October 2020. So it's been in a few festivals, obviously, over the last year as well. And then, as I say, probably going into 2022. As far as the festivals are concerned, like I did kind of course correct partway through, because as I say, in the beginning, you do get a few not selected notifications from some festivals, and you kind of go, okay, maybe, maybe this film isn't enough of a horror to do well in the horror festivals. Like, for example, it didn't get into Ravenna, which is a huge horror film festival in Italy. It didn't get into Abattoir, which is a huge one in Wales. So I was like, okay, maybe it's not, it isn't gory enough to be a strict horror. Maybe I'll try comedy film festivals. Then we got into the Gelas Comedy Film Festival in Russia. We won as best horror comedy in Seattle. So I think it's actually, it leans much more into the kind of the comedy tongue-in-cheek side of things. So having done that course correction, it seems to be doing an even better job in festivals now than it was doing.
Yeah.
So sometimes you just don't know. When our the music composer, Stephen McKenna, did an amazing job at kind of, when we were making the film, we were saying to ourselves, is this a comedy? Is it a horror? Is it a family drama? What the heck is this thing? And it was when he made the music that it really kind of pulled it all together and allowed the flow to work, where we could go from comedy to horror kind of seamlessly. And then kind of gave us a bit more of an impression that it's a dark comedy more than anything else. So that's, it's definitely leaning in that direction now as far as festival is concerned. So hopefully we'll get into a few more over the next few months.
That's great.
And then, please God, stream a service after that.
And I guess will you be releasing the soundtrack as well along with that?
I think Stephen, at one point Stephen put the soundtrack up because it was in his contract that he could do what he wanted with the soundtrack. So I think he had it up on SoundCloud at one stage. I don't know if he took it down since then, but it's definitely available somewhere, I think.
Great. So if you can't see the movie yet, we teased you with 2 minutes already, you might be able to listen to the soundtrack on SoundCloud, which would be great, because that will give you a nice little kind of an idea as well of kind of the flow of the film.
Yeah, that's true.
In a way, isn't it?
That's true, yeah.
That's great. And obviously you're still in promo mode. You're still, I mean, it's mad. I guess with movies, it's different, right? Because it's such a grander thing compared to, I mean, an album obviously as well is quite grander. But movies, it seems to take a while. It's a 2-year process, kind of. Is that a normal kind of thing where you sort of do the festival circuit for a while, then you're hoping to get snagged by a streaming service or independent cinemas and things like that? Is that kind of the process? It's a long-term kind of...
Yeah,
how often then would you do movies? Like, what's the kind of idea? Do you have a vision on that? Or
in an ideal situation, I mean, like, the thing for us was, as soon as Follow the Dead was ready to go, the pandemic hit, so I couldn't go out and film anything for the last 2 years. I would have loved to. I have a few short films that I wanted to make so that I could kind of try out a few different things, just in terms of techniques and story ideas. Does this work? Does that work? You don't want to try those things out on a feature film. You try them out in shorts, see do they work, and then you can move them into your features if you want. So I was going to get that done. I have a few short films written, but of course that kind of had to get pushed to the wayside because of the pandemic. So now that things are kind of opening up a little bit again, in the new year I hope to shoot a couple of new films, and then with any joy we'll be shooting the sequel to Follow the Dead at the end of next year.
Brilliant.
The plan, as long as the funding goes okay, but I've got the script almost ready to go.
So. Fantastic, man, fantastic. And guys at home, feel free to add any questions or comments in. You can ask Adam absolutely anything. Yeah.
Anything at all.
Absolutely anything at all. He's here with us live. Yes, I can almost touch him. He's right beside me. So do pop your comments in right now, and we can, or pop your questions in more so. And if you have anything, of course, it's always interesting. I mean, it's just interesting, the fact that we have somebody from the film industry. It's exciting because we're used to having musicians, so it's shaking up things a little bit. I'm absolutely curious about so many things. So I'm sure if you guys at home have any questions to ask him, now's the time, because he's a busy man. He ain't got time for your Facebook messages, guys. Now is the time, right? We're focusing on that. So pop them in now. We also have a fun segment. We kind of forgot about that almost.
Right, okay. I'm terrified.
Are you terrified? Good.
But also excited.
Excited.
It's a weird mix of emotions.
It's a mixture of emotions. So we can crack into our fun segment, and then if there's any questions in the meantime, feel free to pop them in, guys. I'll highlight them, and my person in my ear will tell me if there's any questions from yourselves, so feel free to do that. Keto, are we going to just launch into this fun segment? I'm a little bit nervous too. Oh, we missed that there. Oh, there we go. Can you even accent, bro? Okay. You can kind of guess where we're kind of going with. Maybe, maybe not. Right. So, Keto, do you want to hop in there and give us a bit of a run through of what we're supposed to be doing?
Well, yeah. So, Dave, this was very last minute, this one.
It looks professional.
Yeah, it looks all right. Well, you see, because you know ourselves, we used to have music people on and all this stuff from usually at time, and there was had to be a change in the schedule this time around. So you were telling me he was an actor.
A lot, so,
You were telling me he was an actor, but so it's more acting based.
It's more acting based, but Adam is very used to
Hopefully,
you know, movies and things. So we went for the kind of we're gonna read out a sentence, but the people at home are gonna choose in what accent we read it out in from a famous actor. Okay, how are you for accents?
I'm not too bad with some. Yeah, definitely.
You've already got an advantage over him.
Well, you see, now you're wrong, Dave, because you didn't tell me that. I didn't know it was meant to be a poll going at home.
Yeah, so we're going to choose.
You write them up earlier, so that's why I wrote them up.
Oh, okay. So Keto's going to decide on who it is. Okay, so Grant. So scratch everything I said. And
so it's more, we're imitating people rather than just the country.
Yeah, we're imitating the person.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So it could be like...
Well, that's a whole different story.
Yeah. It could be Pacino, Schwarzenegger.
Yeah, well, there's only a few of them there, but I made the first one easy to kind of get you into the, you know what it is, you know?
Yeah. Okay, let's see how this goes. Right, so Sylvester... So am I going first then?
If you want. It's a very simple one, but it's just to show you that it'd be a quote from a different person.
Okay.
And you have to try and read it as Stallone, you know?
Oh, God. Yeah, we did this before with like country accents and it just went... Horrible. It went horrible. I'm so bad at this. Am I doing this one?
Guess so.
All right, so it's Get to the Chopper with Sylvester Stallone. So
I get a bit of music going for you there.
Get a bit of music. We got the Rocky music going.
No, I don't have any of that stuff.
Copyright infringement.
Oh yeah, actually, yeah, you're right. Adrian, get to the chopper. Get to the chopper.
It's not bad.
Get to the chopper. All right, that's it. I'm done. No more. I'm glad you gave me a short one. Okay.
Yeah, because they get longer.
They get longer as they come along. Okay, so that's my one. Guys in the chat, you can let us know whose accent you think is better each round. We've got three rounds. So I did my one there. And
I have to do Arnie on my days.
Adam's got to do Arnie. Wow, that's a long one. Come on, that's a bit. Jesus Christ. Wow. Okay.
That's very long. Okay.
It's a Rocky quote.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
You, me, or nobody is going to hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done.
That's very good, man. What?
I'm gonna give him a thumbs up.
Give him a thumbs up. Right. That
I forgot
great.
To give you your.
An all too familiar sound for me. But that was very good accent.
Yeah, it's pretty good, man.
I was terrified.
Yeah. So I was a bit worried getting this made up because I didn't know how anyone would be able to do it.
I'm loving the pictures.
I'd be terrible.
I'm loving the effort on this one. I'm loving it. Okay, so let's see next. Dwayne Johnson, so The Rock. Okay. Oh, geez, these are kind of tough, very specific. Great photo.
I'll turn myself off there.
I'm missing the side of that word, actually.
Abs, is it?
Is it abs? Okay, yeah. So let me try and just picture a scene with him first. Not that it's going to help at all.
Well, I'll tell you who it was. It was Derek Zoolander's quote.
Oh, yeah. No, I know that. I'm just trying to picture a scene with The Rock in it because I can't even remember his voice.
Just do it like where he was when he was a wrestler. He did a lot of pauses.
If you
and stuff,
smell!
Didn't he?
I can't. Just because we have chiseled abs and stunning features doesn't mean that we still cannot die in a freak gasoline fight accident.
That's it. In fairness, that was a hard one.
That was our play the sound. Let's just get it over with.
Yeah.
Play the sound.
I had something else there for you, didn't I?
Yay!
No, that's a boo.
Oh.
That's a boo.
Yeah, cool. We're on next.
It started positive and then went negative.
Oh, wow.
I'm glad I didn't get him. Like, this guy is a hard. I'd say you do a good one.
He's actually more difficult to get than...
He is quite difficult, isn't he?
Okay. What is your name? It doesn't matter what your name is if you can smell what the rock is cooking.
Wow, that is fucking great, man. What the fuck?
I don't think I did the voice right. It's just the pauses.
I think you got the high kind of at the enunciations kind of quite well. Yeah, no, that was pretty good. That was pretty good.
Yeah, yeah.
Great, all right, let's see. Samuel Jackson, oh my God, guys.
Just put an F-bomb everywhere.
And that's actually a Christopher Walken quote.
Is it? Okay, yeah. Okay. I'm motherfucking sick of these motherfucking snakes. I haven't killed anybody since 1984. God damn his soul to burn for eternity in fucking hell for making me my hands dirty.
I'll give you. It was all right. I see what you were trying to do there. You were trying to like get into the role.
He does shout a lot as well.
He does.
Sean's giving you a total hard time here.
Yeah. It's good we can't hear him.
I think it was about 4 out of 10 there from him.
I'll take it.
I'm giving you about a 7 for...
7?
I'll give you a 7.
I wish my chat isn't updating. I have to update my chat to see what you guys at home are saying. And we've got one last one for Adam.
Oh, wow.
Ben Stiller.
Ben Stiller?
That's a tough one.
Oh, can I do it as Zoolander?
We can do Zoolander.
Yeah, well,
I'll do it as Zoolander. Yeah,
yeah. And it's Marlon Brando quote from Godfather.
Okay.
Now you come and say, Don Corleone, give me justice, but you don't ask with respect. You don't offer friendship. You don't even think to call me Godfather.
Brilliant. Wow, that's fucking good.
Yes.
Fantastic.
Only for the fact that I had to do it as Zoolander.
Yeah,
just Ben Stiller, I was going nowhere.
He's quite plain. You need to get him on a character. So it's quite
definitely.
Subtle, I suppose. So no, that's really good. There you go. This might inspire you to get back into acting. You never know.
As an impressionist.
Oh, we got another one. Oh, yeah. That's the quote. Are we doing Marlon? Oh, I'm doing one now as well. Oh, Jesus. Marlon Brando.
Put an egg in your mouth.
Yeah, I just put my... I tuck my tongue in my front lip.
It's a quote from Conor McGregor.
Why would I want to train at the bum gym? I train my own people. I have since the day one. That man needs to get his facts straight before I roll in the gear and buy that gym. I make you an offer you cannot refuse.
That's probably the best one.
I got Conor McGregor.
That was the best one I did. That was the best one I did.
Oh, do I have to do Conor?
You got to do Conor.
Oh, wow. That's weird because it's an Irish accent. Okay. He over enunciates at the end of certain words as well, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Okay. I have had it with these goddamn snakes on this goddamn plane. That was the worst one I did. Easily. It's too much like, it's too close to
actors. Yeah, it's very close to home. Yeah. Great.
Yeah, cool.
That's it. Thank God. I hope I don't have to do another one now. Because I don't think I could put myself through that again. Accent, bro? Thanks so much, Keto, for setting that up for us. Really appreciate it. Nice, bit of crack. Kind of tosses a load of stuff in the air. Very random. Kind of puts us out of our comfort zone. Hey, did you enjoy that?
I enjoyed that a lot more than I said to you when I came in, just don't have me dancing.
Everybody keeps saying that after the dancing episode, and I keep saying, yes, we're going to do dancing. We're going to bring it back.
But he needs a trophy just for doing it.
Yeah, no, true. It is, it really, because you're out of the seat, like, as in you're out of your comfort zone. I'm behind the desk, you're sitting on the comfy couch, and then you have to kind of get up and do something.
And I don't see any whiskey, so I wasn't going to be moving at all.
No, I mean, maybe that'll be the trick, maybe.
Probably.
We need to get a whiskey going or something. That might, lubricate the feet, lubricate the joints, bit of Jameson, absolutely. Well, Jameson, if you're a sponsor out there, you know our email at this stage. And guys at home, I don't have the chats up. I actually don't have the thing, unfortunately, so I can't see your comments at the moment. But thanks for sticking with us, and we'll check it out now. I might see if there's any questions coming up because we missed a little bit of our Q&A here. We got Norveg7, will Adam join you in your sketches in the future? Ooh, that sounds like a question for me. You're supposed to ask Adam questions. What do you think, Adam? Would you like to join us on one of our sketches?
I'm happy to do some sketches, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, great. I mean, you're a very busy man. You're a very busy man. So, I mean, would love to have you. It'd be great to work with some actors and not myself for change, especially after those accents, those impersonations. Adam, Sean, son of Mick, thanks for the specification there. Adam, are you going to sing in a future soundtrack?
Yeah, Sean, son of Mick, is a friend of mine, and he knows well how much I have to do my absolute best to fight myself away from a microphone, normally speaking, because, yeah, anytime I get a chance to sing. I was at my brother's wedding before I gave my best man speech. I started singing into the microphone. So, yeah, I'm almost certainly going to make my way into a soundtrack at some point.
Great. So, like, with regard to singing, actually, would it be something that you would see as, like, ever taking up on a, not necessarily a professional level, but having a band? Would that be something that you'd like to do at any stage, or has it been something that ever crossed your mind?
It was the first thing that ever crossed my mind. I was singing as early as I could talk, and I would have absolutely loved to, like, yeah, being a pop star, rock star, whatever, would have been my number one dream, to be honest. And I always just kind of had the feeling that it was the hardest thing to, like, I can make my own movies, and they will, you know, with any joy, getting other people that are talented involved, they will be successful. But trying to become a famous artist, I think, is probably, like, a musician, is probably the hardest thing in the world to do. And I have so much respect for anybody who gives it a go and actually makes something of themselves from doing it, because I just think it just seems to me to be such a difficult market to break into. So that's why I went with my second love, which was movies, but music was number one.
Yeah, that's really interesting. It's like people in the music industry would see, like, oh my God, it's so hard to do a movie. I mean, all the work that's involved.
Maybe I just had my wires crossed, but I just felt like making movies was a simpler thing, to be honest.
Yeah, no, that's absolutely.
You have full control from start to finish. I think with the music, you know, you can't make music without a good producer. Like, it's so much harder to do all of your own stuff. I don't play any instruments, I just sing, so.
Enya's asking, can you give us a few bars?
A few bars.
You have the mic in front of you. I think she means of singing now, not a...
a few bars of... what are we talking?
Don't worry, we're not going to put you on the... Exactly, yeah. What are we talking? Go for
Vin. When you're told to sing, you can't think of a song. That's the problem.
That's true. It was like, you know, when we were talking about the accents, we were like, oh, we should have a sentence to say, because it's like sometimes I get asked, you know, my parents are Polish, and it's like, oh, say something in Polish. And I'm like, I just say something, the word in Polish, like, because I can't think. But I'm just seeing your comments there, guys. Thanks for popping them all in. We missed you out for a little bit. Good to see you. Andy's asking, how are you planning on raising the funding for your next film?
So
I think we spoke about it a little bit.
Yeah, just with the American streaming service that are looking to buy Follow the Dead, they have expressed an interest in the sequel as well. So that will be the next feature if that all goes ahead. If not, then it'll be a case of probably submitting scripts to Screen Ireland, which is kind of the typical Irish way of doing it. You got to impress somebody in there.
Great, great. Lucid Dream Free, just more cowbell. Yeah, for the Christopher Walken segment. There you go. So you got 100%. So 8 people voted. Although your name is Sean up here for some reason. I think Josh had a little bit of a confusion with the names. But we know who you mean. That's great.
Sean Adam William.
And Sean says, what kind of bars? Whisper Mars and Twix. Adam, it's been an absolute pleasure having
Thanks
you on the show.
Me.
Thanks for breaking us into the film industry, a fascinating industry, something that, you know, I'm very highly interested in. And it's just great to see you again after, I mean, it's been a couple of years, so it's great to see you doing so well. I wish you the very best for obviously the future endeavors, the future project. But of course, with Follow the Dead, there's still so much more to see from that. Obviously, the whole movie as well. I can't wait for it to come out. So do let us know when it does come out for us
absolutely.
To watch.
Cheers.
And is there anything else you wanted to finish on? Is there anything you'd like to say before we let you go?
No, can I just comment on, like, thanks. First of all, thanks for having me in. It's the first studio interview that I've done. It was great. I love what you're doing. And guys, honestly, this studio is tremendous. Like, fair play. It's absolutely a wonderful wonderful, wonderful set, and I think the production value in here is obviously amazing. So from a filmmaker, I'm obviously going to comment on the production value.
Well, there you go. That's absolutely perfect. Maybe we'll get you in to record a song or something for the next one. You never know. Get you singing.
I'd love it.
Yeah, that's awesome. So that's Adam. William Cahill, guys, his information is in the description below, by the way. You can check him out right now, and you can check out all the details on Follow the Dead, and of course, all of his other movies, which he acted and then also directed as well. So do check it out. On a note, actually, yeah, guys, have you been receiving like those scam calls lately? Like, have you ever gotten
every other day?
It's crazy, isn't it? There's like so many of them now.
It's over the top.
Yeah, it's absolutely crazy. Keto, have you been getting those? And let us know in the comment section, guys, as well. Have you been getting scam calls? It's a massive thing now. I think our numbers are out.
Yeah, ever since the HSE got bleeding, where am I? I'm down there, I go up here. Ever since they got hacked, didn't they?
Yeah. Bleeding. Yeah, it's such a nuisance because you don't, like, you think it's somebody important ringing you. You never know. You have to kind of answer them pretty much, like. So I got scam called there recently as well, and they're getting really high tech with it. Like, I actually thought it was a mate ringing me. And, yeah, anyway, I'll play the clip. Keto, do you have the clip there? And by the way, we'll be back very shortly with our next guest.
Shouldn't answer it.
Hello?
Hey, man.
Paul, how are you, man? Jesus, I didn't know who you were. Your number's on private.
Yeah, man, I know.
How's things?
Oh, it's just been mad busy.
Yeah, listen, no worries at all, man. No, I know you're busy. It's all good.
I know. I keep telling you that I'm gonna do stuff and then it turns out that I can't do it. It's just the way it is at the moment. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I would love to do all that stuff again, man. I miss the indie drive. I miss doing all the sketches with you, you know. But I know you're busy, like, you know, so it's all good. Whenever you're ready, you know, just be in touch. Give me a shout, you know.
Well, it was good talking to you.
Yeah, no problem, man.
Bye.
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 Bye. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Who's this ringing me again? It's probably Paul again.
Oh, come here, sorry for ringing you again.
No worries, man.
Come here, I just wanted to... Is your mother's maiden name still the same?
What?
Yeah.
My mother's maiden name? Why would you want that?
Oh, right. Right. I know, silly question.
Very silly question.
And your first pet, what was he called again?
My first pet?
Ah, yeah. No.
My first pet. Why are you asking me these questions?
I'm just that type of person. I'm just a weirdo.
You're just getting to know me.
These weird questions.
You're just getting to know me. That's all right.
Go on. I'll talk to you in a while.
All right. See you later, buddy.
Cheers, buddy. Sorry for bothering you.
No worries.
Bye.
See ya. Ah, Jesus. Paul again. Hello?
Yeah, I know. Third time ringing.
Third time lucky, I guess, isn't it?
But, yeah, no, I just needed you to do something for me.
Yeah, sure, what's up?
So, I just need you to...
Press 1.
What?
Yeah, I'm just gonna need you to press 1 on my phone.
Is that you with the voice changer?
Yeah, it's just a PBS number has been used for criminal activity.
Yeah, don't be messing, man. Come on.
It's gonna be lead manager. If you don't press 1.
Paul.
Need to press 1.
Listen, I'm not pressing 1, man. That's fucking weird. You sound one of those scam callers, like.
Press 1 now.
You're messing, right? Paul? Hello?
Well, look, I'll let you go anyway, all right? Go on, it was good talking to you. Bye. Go on. Bye. 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 Bye.
And we're back, and that was our sketch with the wonderful Archie. Of course, Archie is back doing sketches with us. And we've got another one coming up as well later on in the show. So stick around for that one as well, of course. It's just great to have him back doing some comedy sketches for us. And that was our first guest as well, Adam William Cahill. The details are in the description, of course. Check him out. You can actually follow the Dead. So type in Follow the Dead and you can check that out on social medias and just see all the updates, like how the film is doing in the circuit. It already won 7 awards, which is absolutely unbelievable. And I'm really looking forward to seeing the whole thing. So we got some teaser clips there. Let us know what you thought of it, actually. It's just great to see and great to be connected with the Irish film industry as well. It just brings a bit of variety to the show. So it's absolutely wonderful. So don't forget as well, guys, we have a Patreon if you are interested in supporting our show. Obviously, you know, you can see us. We're in this wonderful studio every 2 weeks. We also take the time to pre-record each of our wonderful artists that we have on the show. So if you're interested in supporting us, you can go as little as you want. We do give away some exclusive goodies at the €10 monthly fee, which includes some secret songs that only patrons have access to. So each artist has been generous enough to record a secret song for us where only you will be able to check out, and they're absolutely fantastic. We have, I think, about 20 secret songs up now. I think it's the 13th episode. We've definitely crossed the 20 mark. We also have some backstage stuff, some bloopers, us having a bit of fun in the studio before the show goes live, and a load of great stuff as well. So do look into that and do consider it, because we do really put a lot of effort into this, and we want to keep going. You know, we really want. We've been going since April, which is it's so great. You know, and I think the show's been getting better every time. So 13th episode already, which is crazy. That flew in. Where
I
did that
agree
come
with
from?
You completely that the show's getting better, but Jesus, that was probably your worst middle section of selling the Patreon I've heard so far.
What
energy, man?
I thought it was fantastic.
I got that energy
section.
Drink. We get going, like.
You got the energy. Give us a bit of that energy drink. Maybe I need a bit of energy.
Don't throw that into him.
Let us know in the comments, guys, how you're enjoying the show so far, of course. And do pop in any questions to our guests as well. In the meantime, we do have a Q&A every time as well, so do feel free. But our next guest, let's pop in. Do you want to say anything? Do you want to criticize me anymore there, Keith?
No, I'm all right. I'm all right. I'm all good.
Thanks.
But yeah,
very
just
much.
Like and subscribe and all that stuff. You know, it can help us along with that kind of thing. Dave already explained it there. There's a lot of things going on in the background, trying to get it more and more, yeah, more and more refined. You know.
A lot of refinition.
All right.
Right, let's move on swiftly to our second guest, who is a indie soul pop artist who rose in the busking scene in Dublin. She released her debut release last year and got onto the one to watch for 2021. She has honed her craft, holding true to her folk background while embracing influence of contemporary artists like Joey Crooks and Big Pig. She has released a fantastic EP called Dreaming. It's up on Spotify right now. 5 fantastic tunes. And she's also got her YouTube channel up with some great music videos from some of those tracks. Good Enough is an absolutely fantastic track up there with a really great music video. I suggest you check it all out, guys. But we have her on the show. Please welcome KK Lewis. Hello. They just keep clapping. There's just clapping going on.
Big audience here.
Massive audience.
Too much people to count.
They love you. What can I say, KK? Great to meet you.
You too.
How's things? How are you keeping?
Really good.
Great.
It was really cold outside.
It's getting freezing now, isn't it?
It is getting freezing. Yeah. A little bit freezing.
Are you busking out there now, or have you taken a break from it?
I've taken a break. I was busking a lot before lockdown. I moved to Berlin for a few months, and I busked there, and it was literally like minus 10 degrees. Okay, no, that was a bit extreme. It wasn't that cold, but it was really cold, and it literally turned me off busking for a while. So I'm taking a break. I'm kind of focusing on just writing and recording full time.
Yeah, what brought you to like Berlin? What was Berlin specifically? Why that city?
Well, it's kind of known as a very kind of like creative and musical city, and a lot of the buskers I know had moved to Berlin and got on really good there. Like the money was really good, and people love musicians over there, so just gave it a shot.
Yeah. And 2 months, were you planning on potentially staying longer, was it? Or what kind of made
you
come back?
I was actually in college when I was there.
Okay, you were meant to be in college.
So I was meant to be in college.
So you're incriminating yourself now.
I was there a few years ago.
It's a long, long time ago.
A long, long time ago. But I was only meant to go for a month, really, and I stayed for an extra month and then came back. But no, I was ready to come home.
Okay.
It's a very intense city. I love it, but it's very intense.
Really, yeah.
Yeah.
And what makes you, what do you like about Dublin that's different to Berlin and brought you back here? Less intense?
Dublin just, I don't know, it's more normal. Maybe it's because I'm so familiar with Dublin. Mm. But even the music scene here and like the open mic nights and the music nights, I don't know, I just, like Dublin can get so repetitive, it can get boring, but I don't know. It's so nice.
I guess if it gets boring, you can always just go out to another city for a little bit and bust.
Go somewhere else, yeah.
That's the great thing as well about, you know, because you play guitar as well, of course, and you sing, so you can just kind of hop on a flight or whatever and just bring your guitar with you and just play music.
Last month I actually went with one of my friends to England and did a bit of a busking tour. Mm-hmm. Well, it was intended to be like a month-long busking tour, but it ended up kind of being like 2 weeks having fun, 2 weeks busking. But like literally I did just that, kind of just brought my busking equipment with me and just busked around, and it was really fun.
Yeah. What kind of equipment would you be using? Like, do you use your own amps and stuff, or is it all acoustic?
I use my electric guitar now more so than my acoustic.
Okay.
But I have like an AER, which is actually an acoustic amp, but the electric sounds nice through it.
Yeah.
And the vocals are so nice through it as well. It was quite expensive, but
it pays off.
It pays off. Like you pay for it, but you make the money back that you pay for it.
Yeah, it's fantastic. And so like your debut release was only last year, right? Is that correct in saying?
I don't know. Every time I meet someone, I'm like, oh, I released my EP a few weeks ago, but it was like,
time is
summer. Like it was like July. It's like mid-July, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. But that's crazy. So like your first release and it's like, throughout the lockdown, right?
Yeah, literally.
So obviously, and how did you find that? Like, obviously, you know, you didn't get a chance to really play in front of a live audience or anything like that. How was that kind of release for you? Obviously, you know, it's not ideal, but were you still able to kind of make it work? And
yeah, it was hard. Like promoting an EP in the middle of lockdown is so difficult. But I have lots of friends around me. So that helped a lot. We had a lot of kind of like release parties and kind of just like random little promo things, like dropping sheets with like the dates and stuff out the window.
I saw that. So you have an announcement video on your YouTube, which is, I actually do check out KK's YouTube channel. It is fantastic. You've three, is it three music videos from three of the songs?
Yeah.
So that's a lot of work. I mean, you're quite busy over the lockdown.
Yeah,
right?
It was because one of my childhood best friends, he is a videographer. So we kind of teamed up at the beginning of lockdown, and like, because I'd planned to do the whole EP and I really wanted it to kind of have a strong visual aspect, because like that's what I've always loved when I watch artists. Like I love when they have a really strong visual aspect to their music.
Sure.
So we kind of just like met up and kind of like did like drafts where we like did storyboarding and then we decided that we wanted to have like a link, like kind of a trilogy. Trilogy.
Yeah, of course, we'll ask Adam. Is Adam gone? Is he? Oh, Adam's gone. Yeah, the movie guy.
The movie guy. Yeah. I was like, who's Adam?
That's fantastic. I mean, the production value is amazing on them. Yeah. I have to say. Yeah.
So it literally was just like me, him, and my friends, kind of just putting in a lot of work. Yeah. To make them come out the way they did.
Yeah, no, it's great. I mean, very creative. You've got a scene, I think you were in the water, isn't it?
And that was Petals. Freezing. That was for Petals, yeah.
Was that outdoor or was that indoors?
That was outdoors.
Jesus.
My mum knew this guy who owned a farm who had a bath in a field that he used to use to feed cows with.
Yeah.
But we ended up using that. But he let us use his house so we could get some hot water into the bath.
Right, okay.
But the hot water goes cold. Because we filmed that literally like last January. And the water got cold very quickly.
Yeah.
And there was like green food dye and everything.
Yeah, I saw that.
It was a lot. Like by the end of the day, I literally was like coughing. Like, get me to bed. But yeah, no, it was really fun.
Yeah, no, very fun. Very creative, and obviously a lot of work put into it. I mean, 5 songs on the EP, and then 3 of them to have a music video is a big feat. Like it's fantastic. What made you choose those 3 songs? So you were saying a trilogy? Are they kind of, is there a connected theme to those 3 songs particularly?
The whole kind of EP was written about like my teenagehood and growing up, and kind of just insecurity, and kind of the idea at the beginning, it was kind of like I'm in this big kind of massive pink dress. I don't know if you saw that, but a girl, Jessica Mabel Anderson, I think that's her full name, she actually designed the big pink. She made it from scratch. She bought all the materials.
Wow.
And shout out to her. She's amazing.
Yeah, yeah.
And the kind of idea was to have this massive big pink fluffy dress. And then at the end of the Pedals music video, you see that dress get set on fire and destroyed. And it's kind of like that kind of growing out of that kind of teenagehood insecurity and kind of becoming a woman and being confident in myself. And
fantastic. Yeah, no, great. That's Petals, A First Bus Home, and Good Enough being the trilogy as well.
Yeah.
And that is up on YouTube. Those 3 are up on YouTube now, guys. So you definitely should check it out. No, brilliant. I had a listen to the EP as well. I think it's absolutely wonderful. You have a great style to you.
Thank you.
And your voice is fantastic. Recorded really well as well. The production is lovely as well. Did you work with the same? I guess you worked with the
same.
Yeah,
I worked with this guy called Dara Hoare. He kind of goes under the name of Paparua for his own music. Mm-hmm. But he used to give my mum singing lessons. Like he used to do those kind of like women group singing lessons, and she actually introduced me to him. He lives up the road from my mum's house. So during lockdown, I moved in to my mum's and just walked up to Dara's house multiple times a week, and just decided to, we were like, let's do a record. Like, let's actually
do
it. Yeah, and we just listened to like, we spent days listening to like loads of vinyls, listening to different types of music. And because I kind of literally came to him with like me and the guitar.
Yeah.
Like just my voice and the guitar. And he was kind of like, hey, let's do this and listen to these kind of artists, and really influenced kind of where I wanted to take my music and the sound.
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, that's why every song is, we wanted every song, because I'm not really sure what my sound is yet. Like my actual,
I saw you mention that in an interview before. You couldn't really define it yet. And
So we wanted every song to have its own thing. Like Loop Now has a lot of Latin influences and that kind of beat. And then Petals is kind of like, was influenced by Kanye West. And then obviously First Bus Home is like a really chilled, laid out. Like they're all have their own kind of thing going.
Do you feel the need to have to define your music into something like a package? Or do you like sort of that variety?
I don't know. Like I've struggled with that a lot because my style of music changes so frequently. And I always feel there's a pressure on artists to have a kind of specific sound, because like a lot of artists be pinned down like for ages because I was busking. Everyone was like, oh, you're a folk singer, and it's like no, like I busk but I'm not a folk singer. But like I think if you put enough into like your craft and you really kind of hone in on that, you kind of will naturally get your sound. It doesn't have to necessarily be like R&B, jazz, folk. You kind of will just find it with your voice and your lyrics. And
absolutely.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, no, that's great. And speaking of music and your music particularly, we're going to play one of your tracks right now. And you guys join us afterwards. We're going to have a Q&A with KK. So get your questions up.
Ooh.
Ask her anything.
Spooky.
Absolutely everything. Anything you want in the comments section, and we'll try to get to as many questions as possible. But for now, enjoy this track by KK Lewis. Thunders, but the sun.
broke me gently. Oh, you just broke me gently.
That was Dreaming by K.K. Lewis, one of three songs, one of four. The fourth one is, of course, behind our Patreon wall, as mentioned before. So only our €10 tier subs can have access to that secret song. And we've also got two more tracks as well coming up very, very shortly. But we're in our Q&A section, guys, so feel free to throw in any of your comments or questions. We're getting some lovely comments from Abigail. I love your music. It's mucho good. Miss Lewis says, great sultry voice. John Hell says, that's a rainy driving tune right there. Lucid Dream for Egypt. Love the name, by the way. Soulful stuff. Enya says, gorgeous voice. Lara Lewis says, do you have a boyfriend, KK?
That's my mum, and she knows the answer to that question.
What's the answer?
I don't have a boyfriend.
She doesn't have a boyfriend, guys. Okay, there you go. Viber Nothing says, wow, absolutely amazing voice. Mums, huh? Always
mums.
With those questions, isn't it? Hi, ma'am, how are you? Welcome to Transmission TV. Thanks for tuning in to see your wonderful daughter. We got Lucid Dream and asking, question for Kate. I love the title for obvious reasons. Is there anything more behind it? Do you take inspiration from your dreams?
Kind of, yeah. Not necessarily my dreams, but more so kind of daydreaming. Like, I daydream a lot. Like, I find it very hard to even, like, pay attention to conversations because I'm always just
kind of... Are you daydreaming right now?
Yes.
Okay, just wanted to clear that up. So am I. I'm a little bit dazed today.
We're
as well.
All daydreaming.
So it's a lot more kind of...
So it's kind of like, yeah, because, like, sometimes I often think, like, because I'm, like, I'm always kind of in my head about things. And I'm, like, I feel like sometimes I'm also, actually living a different life inside my head, like compared to my real life. So it's kind of like dreaming, kind of like my alternate life. I don't know. I don't really know. It makes sense in my head, but I don't know how to articulate it.
Is that then articulated maybe then through your music, I guess, right?
So yeah, in a sense.
The music explains
it
in a way.
Yeah.
Okay, that's interesting. Tsunami Studio says, why is that lad dressed up as Top Gun? That's a very good question, actually. I don't know why. And I lost my aviators. A very good question. Lucy Dream says, good owl Irish mammies. Absolutely true. Miss Lewis, what is the situation with her college? She mentioned she was in Berlin. Oh, Jesus, here we go. I don't know. Should we move on or do you want to?
No, like I'm still in college, so it's okay.
What are you studying?
I'm studying music in college.
Are you in BIM?
In BIM,
okay,
yeah.
Fantastic.
I'm in third year in BIM.
Great.
But it's only... It's kind of like, it's not like as full-time as a normal, well it is, it's a full like 4-year degree, but it's not as full-time as other college courses, so it's kind of, you can kind of leave for a while and come back.
Because you're missing out a lot of classes basically.
Yeah, little bit.
You can defer a year, right? You can do that
you
kind
can.
Of stuff, right?
You can,
so that's pretty common.
But it's going good at the moment, going strong.
Are you doing songwriting?
Songwriting.
How are you finding that sort of the teachers there and stuff like that with sort of relation to your music style? Are they kind of nurturing in that kind of way?
Yeah, like it's kind of difficult in a sense because I taught myself how to play the guitar, I taught myself how to write. It's kind of like everyone. So you kind of develop a style and a way that you write music. But in BIM you kind of are forced to kind of write in certain like specific genres, like write a rock song or write a song. Like you have to kind of write debriefs.
Right.
And it's like it's challenging, but like a lot of people kind of give out about it, but I think it's kind of good because it makes you because you'll always have your own way of writing.
Yeah. And it puts you out of your comfort zone as well, right?
KK's
laughing because Adam's wearing the aviators. All right, Adam, bring yourself onto the show. Come on. There's Adam.
Hey.
Let's get a wide shot of Adam.
Round of applause for Adam.
Rarely seen the Adam on the show. And there we go. Absolutely complete.
Here's the aviators.
There we go. I got to rewatch that movie.
I wish I had sunglasses now.
Do we have sunglasses for KK as well?
Is there any more aviators?
Wait, do I have? Oh, look here. Actually, there you go.
Whoa.
There you go.
These are like colored ones.
Yeah, those are like. That's pretty much aviator-y
We are the aviators.
And I can't even see properly through this.
Neither can I.
It doesn't really help, right?
These are really big sunglasses.
They are big, yeah. They're kind of...
They look kind of take up half your face.
My face is kind of big, I guess. I don't know.
They want to be really sunny.
Yeah, no, they're actually great. They're actually great. But, like, I rarely obviously get to wear them. But I'm glad you got to try them on.
Hey, me too.
Yeah, yeah. So, let's do our fun segment.
Oh, I'm so scared.
Why are you scared?
I don't know what to expect.
Right, so it's a dance-off.
Oh my God, no.
You like dancing, don't
you? I can't dance. No, I really can't dance.
No, we're only messing. I keep doing that. That joke's going to run dry. It has run dry. I'm never going to say that joke again.
That's okay.
We did it once on the show and everybody's been asking like, oh, I hope I don't have to dance.
So, I'll come once I don't have to dance.
You don't have to dance. Don't worry. But Keto, do you want to introduce our fun segment? Fun using the word very sparingly here. We don't know if it'll be fun or not. We're risking it.
It could be awful.
But our interesting segment, we haven't figured out a name. Anyway, Keto, play the clip.
Hey.
Oh.
What the F are they saying?
L.
Y.
F. D.
N. L. B. J. J. F. K.
P.
N. W.
Okay. So, Keto, will I give you honors to explain this one? So Keto's going to give us a little bit of an explanation here.
Maybe. Yeah, so there's a lot of people probably on who's here today that haven't actually been really watching the show as much, or they weren't. There's some in there. I've seen some of our old usuals in there, but some don't. And Dave's been like giving me grief about stuff being a bit too easy at times.
Never said that.
You did. You said it once or twice. So I don't know.
What have I done?
I kind of made something a bit far too hard, man. Like, no one's going to get anything.
Okay.
So I'd say just make a laugh of it all, to be honest.
I'll try my best.
I hope it works. So
this is me basically having to compensate for Keto's lackluster presentation.
Yeah, I hope it works. So basically, it's song lyrics that are hard to hear. You know when you get a song and you're like, what the fuck are they saying?
Not like curse on this show.
Yeah, well, yeah, you know, you're
alright. I'm only messed.
It's like...
We wind each other up a little bit too much. Okay. So this is, that is it, Keto. No, absolutely. So, you know the way you, exactly.
Yeah, so just basically, and then Dave was like, you should
just
do
like,
that.
Why am I explaining it again?
He was like, you should do that. And then I was like, right, he leaves it to me, you know? It's like, find some songs and do that. So I was like, okay. So then I just started finding some tunes that I thought I had hard lyrics, but
they're probably really easy because Keto.
No, they're not. They're really not.
All right, okay. So we have to guess the lyric, basically.
Okay.
All right, let's give it a go.
Right.
So
yeah,
I'll
cool.
go first. I'll put myself in the firing range.
Thank you so much.
Don't worry. This is what.
Yeah.
I do.
Right. Okay. So I think.
And by the way, guys at home, feel free to pop in your suggestions as well on what you might think this artist is saying, because it's.
Yeah, we can do it that way.
It's going to be pretty interesting.
So here's the first one. I hope it all works because we didn't really get to test it, so.
Yeah.
Good sense, ill sense, crippling mankind. Dead kings, many things I can't define.
Okay. Good. That's actually hard because there's a lot of sentence there. I mean, it's a long sentence. There's a lot of sentence. Good sense. Can you play it again? Do you know it?
Good sense, ill sense, crippling mankind. Dead kings, many things I can't define.
Oh God, good sense, aero sense. That's what it sounds like he's saying. Crippled mankind. Right, that's definitely it.
Mm-hmm.
The second part.
That's meant to be the hard part.
Oh, is it? Oh, crippled mankind. Good sense, aero sense. I know that's not it, but like, I can't think of anything right now. Crippled mankind, and the second part of it?
One more time. You get three times.
Okay, three times.
Right, let's see.
Good sense, ill sense, crippling mankind. Dead kings, many things I can't define.
Dead kings, many... Dead dreams... No. Dead kings, many dreams... And I forgot the end.
it's kind
of... We'll all be fine.
Yeah, well, no.
Damn it. Let's see it.
So hopefully it works on this now. No, that's wrong. I have to go back all the way.
That was a joke. That was the joke. It was him all along.
Right.
All right, so we have to mute. So we're going to get copyright striked again, guys. Lucid Dreaming says, innocence. Oh. Innocence, that you're right. You're right. How did that get me?
Yeah, you should ask the crowd. Just ask the crowd, because this is a hard, this is like the easiest one.
Oh, great.
So,
well, that's the easiest one.
yeah, now we're in trouble. It's my fault. Good sense, ill sense, crippling mankind. Dead kings, many things I can't define. Oh, cool. Now it all makes sense to me.
Yeah, when you see it, you see.
Yeah, when you see it, you see it.
Yeah. So we'll keep it going anyway.
Yeah, cool.
Keep
KK, you ready for this? Flowing.
And don't worry, just get them all wrong. Who cares anymore?
Yeah. It's all good. It's all in good fun. Absolutely.
So the next one.
Blinded by the light. Wrapped up like a douche, another runner in the night. Okay.
Burning in the Nights. After that, I don't know what it said.
Try it again, you get three plays. I actually know this one.
Somebody
I love this band.
In the comments, come through. I'm not watching.
Do you know what? I'm going to just minimize that. Because no cheating on this show, right? KK, I know it's your first time here. Because no cheating on this show.
I was born to cheat.
Are you? Sorry, play that again.
Play it again, play it again.
That was my bad.
Like, it just sounds like Muffles to me.
It sounds like douche.
It sounds like Muffles.
It sounds like douche, but it's not douche.
Burning by the lights. Something, something. Burning by the lights.
Okay, it's Manfred Mann. Excellent band. Love it. There's actually some other great tracks that aren't very known.
What's it say, Dave?
Blinded by the light. Revved up like a deuce. Another runner in the night.
Oh, very good, buddy. Very good.
Don't know what that means. At all. Although he says it like douche.
I know, everyone thinks he says douche.
Which is why I love the song.
Like, how did you get that? That sounded like Muffle to me.
Because
how did
I know
you
the
get
song.
That?
Okay. I used to sing this in the shower.
Well, you're using your douche.
Fuck's sake. All right, Lara Lewis, Blinded by the Light. Yes, you got it.
I'm only joking with you, man.
You're not. You already said it. It's too late. Okay. I'm so sorry.
Right, so,
I'm so sorry. That was a good one, though. I like that one. Okay. This is hard.
It is hard.
Are you having a laugh?
Very famous song, man.
It's Daft Punk. It's Daft Punk, isn't it? Can I sound like
What's
I'm...
What's he actually saying, though? That's the question.
But I thought I'd be at least sound a little bit impressive by at least naming the artist. Do you know that song?
No.
Okay. So...
Do you not know it, Dave?
Yeah, obviously. It's Daft Punk.
Yeah,
it's
Instant
from the
Crush
album,
as Julian Casablanca.
Random Access Memory album. Absolutely fantastic. I'm stalling here because I don't have a bleeding breeze.
It is hard. It's can very I get hard at least, lyrics.
Because it's too long as well. Like, I mean, guys.
Yeah.
Lucid Dreaming says good luck. Okay, let's go again. Can we just break it down? Can you play the first?
I can't really.
Okay. Let's try it again then.
I should have done them a bit, like, definitely more.
That's okay. That's okay. Let's try it
again. It's a lot to remember.
I'll never be alone again. I mean, I'll never be alone again. I'll never be alone again.
I'll try and do it. I
something at the
it.
End of the day or something. Or something with day is the second sentence. Can you slow it down?
No.
Could you take out the music? What can you do, Keith? Jesus.
Keith, how about you come out here and sing us the songs and then we'll try and guess.
Yeah, I can't do that either.
Actually, yeah, he can do it. He's just... He can do everything.
I'll just play
Keith
the thing.
He can do everything.
Because it is, like, it's very quick lyrics. I should have made it shorter.
Okay. That's fine. I'll never be alone again. I got the day part right.
Yeah.
That's very good. Very, very, great song. I like that. Did you like Daft Punk?
I do like Daft Punk.
Yeah. Do you know that album, the Random Access Memory, is like their most recent one, which was actually...
No, I haven't listened to that one.
It was quite a... Well, it's not recent anymore, but they...
2013.
Yeah, it feels still recent, because I remember it coming, and they haven't released anything since, pretty much, right?
Well, they're broken up now.
They broke up last year.
Yeah, I saw that. Sad.
Sad times.
Sad.
Yeah, sad times. So there's space for a duo from that kind of genre now, because like, nobody, they're gone. So Keto, maybe you want to slap a mask on with me?
What's that?
Never mind. We'll talk later.
Hey, let's your time just, to shine.
Oh, you're going to do another cover band, are you?
We'll do another cover band. No, we'll have our own one. Derek Bird said, KK Lewis is probably one of the best singers on Grafton Street.
Hey.
Whoa.
Philip Shear, haven't seen KK on Grafton Street in a while.
Yeah.
Just like, yeah.
I actually did go out one of the days last week. No, it was actually like a month ago. But I got too nervous and I went home.
Really?
Yeah, it's because I know so many people in Dublin. So I just, you're stopping every 5 minutes to be like, hi, and that awkward conversation. And they watch you for a few minutes and it's like, oh, should I go now or should I stay and watch you sing? And they don't know whether to put money in your case or not. And it's just, yeah, I don't know. It's not a fun time.
It sounds like a lot of hassle. Yeah,
exactly. Yeah.
I wouldn't bother either.
Not for the moment. Not for the moment.
Well, there you go, guys. That's the reason. Stop going up to her and being awkward, right? Just throw the money in and
I'm
watch it at a distance.
I'm awkward enough as it is.
No. All right, so let's see the next one. This is your turn, is it? Yeah, I think it's KK's turn.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go.
I'll probably skip one there or something now.
If it's a hard one, skip it.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. Well, they're all hard.
How many are there?
There's like another four 50. Of them.
There's four of them. Okay, okay. Let's just slap one up there. Let's go. Guys in the comments as well, keep your questions coming in. We can still have a chat with KK while we're doing this, so do pop any questions.
So we're gonna go into a different genre altogether, you know?
Okay, we're gonna go into a different genre.
Okay.
We're going down.
I know this song. But go again.
Jeez, this reminds me a second of school.
And simping for the wrong team.
Simping? That wasn't even there back then, was it?
But
that
no, would make that's what I heard.
That's very good, right? So let's go. It does sound like simping.
Doesn't it? Yeah.
What a tune. It's a shame you missed out on the chorus because
yeah,
it's
excited.
Such a, I'm getting like nostalgia here.
Yeah, so now we're going to the famous of hard to understand lyricists.
Is it Nirvana? Is it?
No, but we're in the same era.
Oh, okay.
Right.
What the fuck, man?
It literally sounds like.
Like there's no effort in that at all. Like he must have been really hungover in the studio or something. Can I get another take, please, of that? That's Sting, obviously, right? Because
no,
because it's
Pearl Jam.
Oh, okay. Sorry, it's kind of always get those two mixed up.
Mix up Sting, Heart of
Gold. What's he saying? Well, that was like Family Guy joke, wasn't it?
Right.
Anyway, I don't know. It's
actually really hard because it doesn't sound anything like what he's saying.
Yeah. Yellow Lobster. Oh, never mind.
I let her start.
I mean.
Yeah, I know.
Never really got into Pearl Jam.
I guess you could just both try and get these together because I don't think switching over matters.
Yeah, I think at this stage.
Hey, this is very serious.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Competition.
Well, yeah. We need buzzers or something.
And we're both losing.
Yeah, I got one.
Hey.
I got one.
That's better than zero.
That is better than zero.
Yeah.
But like, you never know. You could still catch up.
Bala 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 ramba, the living sequel.
Yeah, I don't know why I picked that one. Like I was just like,
is it? Is it not Bamba?
Bamba la bamba.
See, I always thought it was, yeah, it was la 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 or whatever.
Ba la 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 bamba.
Well, it's not, though. Ba la la la
la bamba. Wait, what? Ba da ba da ba ba la.
Bailar la bamba.
Oh.
Bailar. Something about dancing.
Oh, yeah. Is there a bailar in there?
There is. There is.
Tito's just like, let me see.
I don't have a clue about the song.
All right, so what's your one?
Boy a bailar a bamba. Boy a bailar a bamba.
Close.
Boy a bailar a bamba.
Well, la, yeah, here, just watch it.
He gave me a Spanish one. It's not even try to guess the hard English. Guess
that
the hard
bad.
Spanish.
But you got
yeah.
That
actually,
was
well,
good,
she
like.
Gets half a point. That's the best.
Hey, I get half a point because I got one of the Spanish words.
Okay, fine.
Yeah, yeah,
fine. That is hard. I actually just thought it was like la 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 la.
There's obviously lyrics.
There's obviously lyrics now. Not obviously lyrics.
Well,
now
I don't know. Like, there seems to be a. You never know, man. There's
you never know.
There's a lot of songs out there that don't have even real lyrics in them and all.
Very true. Real lyrics. I mean.
Yeah. Like I mean, this next one, man.
Going like
yeah, serious? I just wanted to try and get all of it.
All like. Of that. Well, Louis.
Oh,
got that.
Oh,
KK, you gonna finish?
You get
that
one-tenth of a point.
I actually wasn't. I zoned out for that.
You zoned out? Okay, yes. KK zoned out of that one. I don't blame you.
I'll be honest about this one. I even searched the internet, and it seems to be divided even on what the lyrics are.
Ooh.
So we just have a. I just kind of.
You actually did some research, Tito.
So we got that part.
Yeah.
We got that part.
Yeah.
maybe someone in the comments would tell us.
Anyone in the comments want to help us? Dave Duggan gives up. Lara says, we sent you to Spain to learn Spanish. Did you go to Spain, did you?
I did. Lived in Spain for a year.
Oh, how was that?
It was really fun.
Did you learn Spanish?
Actually, I came back fluent.
What? You were giving out about the Spanish.
I know, but I wanted to just get a point.
Okay. You got a half point, though.
I got a half point.
That, you did, yeah.
Before you knew that I was fluent in Spanish.
Wow, well, there we go. Thanks. I'm glad your mom's in the chat to kind of give
hey,
us
thanks,
all the...
Hey, thanks, Mom.
The truth about you. Maybe we'll bring her in next time just to get all the rest of the stuff. So that was there you go. Is that it?
Yeah, well there was one more there, but it's a bit of a mad one. Like so.
Well go on, hey, let us have it now.
It's the last one,
I
didn't even
you
know the lyrics.
I want David in particular to like get this one straight out. Chagaron, 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 chagaron.
Okay. Great song, first of all.
Yeah.
Let me just say.
Yeah. All six verses of it, like, you know.
Chacaron.
Oh, we got that part right.
There isn't, the name of the song isn't actually called Chacaron.
Is it not?
I don't think so. I think it's actually called.
Yeah, well, someone actually, like, transcribed the whole thing out online, so.
You're joking me.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm not even going to try. Chacaron. Chacaron, chacaron, chacaron. I never would have gotten that. I never would have gotten that. Amazing, amazing.
I don't know what any of it means.
People
but...
on the internet, huh? I mean,
yeah,
that's amazing. Yeah, fair play to you. Keith, thanks so much for setting that up. What the F are they saying? KK, what did you think of that? Did you enjoy that?
That was so much fun.
Was it?
It was.
Excellent. So great to have you. Guys, if you have any last questions, do pop them in.
This is your last chance ever.
Your last chance ever.
To ask the most excruciating, it's not the word, ask the most...
I mean, it could be.
Excruciating questions, possibly.
Yeah. Is there any other upcoming stuff, any recordings, anything else you're planning for the end of the year?
Yeah, well, I am planning to do... Obviously, I never got to do EP launch or a gig.
Yeah. So you had something in the Soundhouse, right, not too long ago. It was 8 months ago or something like that.
Oh, yeah, it was like a live stream.
Not the same.
It's not the same.
Tell us about your kind of real gigs.
My last gig was kind of like just before I went to Berlin. It was like just before lockdown. And it was the Whelans Ones to Watch gig.
Great.
And that was kind of the first... kind of starting gig, and then everything shut down. So I kind of want to, like, I had my kind of, my first ever show I put on was in the Vintage Room in Workman's. It's just, I don't know if you've ever been. It's like this cute little room.
I haven't been inside it, but I know of it.
It's so cute. It's so, it has these little pictures on the wall and like really cute wallpaper. But it's like, I think I max 50 people in there.
Oh, is it in, whereabouts is it?
In Workman's.
In Workman's, okay.
It's like
okay.
The little door on the left.
Okay, cool.
As you're going upstairs. But I was thinking about doing kind of to get used to playing live again, doing a little comeback show or doing like kind of a limited tickets
awesome.
Kind of event thing. And I'm also working on my next project at the minute as well. So
is it going to be under KK Lewis or are you going to do
under your thing? Under KK Lewis.
Just a couple of songs?
Yeah, there's a lot of songs kind of running at the moment that I think are a lot better than the last ones. But yeah, hopefully be out by the end of the year, next year.
Fantastic, great, looking forward to that. And of course you can see KK's fantastic EP, Dreaming. You can listen to it on Spotify right now, 5 fantastic tracks, and also the awesome music videos to accompany 3 of those tracks as well. I urge you to check it out. I know a couple of you have already checked it out and said it was amazing. So the link is in the description there for KK's Facebook, and then that should lead you to every other place. And hopefully we'll hear more from you in the next coming weeks and months
hopefully.
With regard to your limited ticket gigs as well. So I wish you the very best with your live performances. Are you
going
to do a duo? Because I know you did a duo for us. Are you going to do, you did a duo with a keys player as well before?
They're kind of my two go-to guys. Like Tyke is my keys player and then Dara is my producer and my guitarist.
Great.
But no, like with my gigs, it'll be like a full band performance.
Drummer.
Yeah.
The full trimmings.
Because I find that really frustrating when I'm playing. It's always like chilled out, but that's just because of like the circumstances and the like, you know, with COVID and everything.
Yeah.
But once kind of everything's back to normal, like I'll have my full band together and
awesome.
Be the full whack.
The full whack, as they say. Absolutely awesome. KK Lewis, such a pleasure to meet you and chat to you. Thanks so much
you
for coming
too. Thank
onto
you so
the
much
show.
For having me.
We're going to leave you guys, and thanks so much for tuning in, everybody, as well. I don't think we have time for any more questions, but we're going to leave you with 2 fantastic tracks by KK, and then we'll be back with, I guess, a little final goodbye from us at Transmission TV. We're also going to play a sketch as well, so don't go anywhere. We've got 1 more comedy sketch from the awesome Archie, and we're going to give you a little bit of an inside to our show in the next 2 weeks, which is a Halloween special. So don't go anywhere. We're going to give away a couple of prizes on that night, and we're also going to let you know who's going to be performing. So don't go anywhere.
You plucked off all my pain. dry. You threw me on the pavement. Decay, dissolve, die. I won't let you take away the only love I have, the one that keeps me sane. That's not saying I'm okay. The words of rhyme, they slither through my veins. So please don't take my love away. I've been riding, riding, riding here for days. You plucked off all my petals. You left me there to dry. The pavement, decay, dissolve, die. You plucked off all my petals. You left me there to dry, dry.
See? So I let the birds set the tone while we wait for the first bus home. I let the birds set the tone, 'cause standing next to you I feel so cold.
And that was the amazing performance from Tsunami Studios with KK Lewis. We're going to be releasing the three performances from the show this evening. Next week sometime, I guess we're going to upload them. We're going to premiere them. So do tune in for that as well. Do subscribe to us, guys, if you haven't already. Just hit that subscribe button right now. Hit the like and do hit the share as well. Share around with your community. We, of course, are here every second week. And we always have an array of fantastic creatives on the show. And we always have pre-records as well. So do tune in whenever you can, guys. It'd be great to have your support, of course. We are still feeling quite young, you know, doing this. And any bit of support is absolutely fantastic. So even a sub like is always counted for us. We're always watching our channel. And it's great to see some of you guys watching again. And great to see the wonderful comments. John Hell saying unreal voice. Miss Lewis saying fabulous voice. Lara Lewis, the whole family, the whole Lewis family in the chat. Welcome, guys. Saying absolutely beautiful. And we got some round of applause from Lucid Dream for Egypt and Dara Dunn Lamb. Round of applause. Guys, thanks so much for checking out our artist today and for supporting them as well. As much as you're supporting us, you're supporting the artists. So don't forget to check out the links in the description that kind of link you to all of our artists today. And of course, we have our Patreon link there as well. If you want to just check out, even you can read the kind of tiers and you can see what those patron tiers offer as well. There's some really great stuff you get in return for supporting our journey here in Tsunami Studios with Transmission TV. So thanks again, guys. We're going to play a comedy sketch, so don't worry, we got another really funny comedy sketch with Archie, of course. And I'll just give you a little bit of what's going to happen in 2 weeks. We've got the awesome Jailbird joining us and the amazing Russell Hogg for our Halloween episode on the 26th of October. So that's 2 weeks from now. Do tune into that, guys. It's going to be great. We're going to have a costume competition so you guys can submit photos of yourselves at home in costume, and we're going to judge and give away a couple of we're going to give away something next in 2 weeks. I think we'll give away a Patreon access for a month. We're going to give away some coffee vouchers and stuff like that. We've been in touch with an awesome cafe just literally a stone's throw away from us called Bump and Grind, and they're a drive-thru coffee cafe even, and they're great. Just really fantastic coffees and really great food as well. I had the cheese and ham toasty there today. It's absolutely delicious. So we're delighted to be collaborating with those guys. So they'll be throwing in a couple of, I think they're throwing in a 50 euro gift card and stuff like that as well, which is great.
The toasties are whopper.
Really good.
And the
mustard sauce they have there as well is just
keeping
fantastic.
Us going there.
It's keeping us going. It's keeping us well fed and energetic as well. So no, really, really great stuff. So just want to give a big shout out to them. So that'll be on the 26th, guys. Do stick around for that. So I think that's everything for today. Thanks again for tuning in. We're going to leave you with this sketch. And then we'll see you all very soon. Don't forget to, stay tuned. We're going to release all the interviews separately as well, so you can rewatch the whole show in segments specific to the artist. And we're also going to release the separate performance for KK Lewis. So have a wonderful rest of your week, guys. Thanks for tuning in. And we're going to leave you with this sketch. Enjoy.
Wait, look, I didn't get the... I should ask the chat, actually. I wanted to start putting more stuff in. I didn't get to play my Mortal Kombat stuff.
Oh, okay.
Elder God defeated.
You know, that would have been great for
Elder
the...
Elder God's invasion.
For the fun segments, that would have been a good time to
Elder
play
God's
that.
Retreat.
I might find a few of them, you know, and put them in there. Let the chat tell me. I could start putting them in and just annoying Dave with them. I like this Mortal Kombat buzz, I don't know.
Yeah.
Maybe give us some suggestions on some other ones, maybe. We can make a team out of it.
Keep that one as toys.
I love it. I'm getting used to it now, you know. I'll finish off with this for you. And then we'll see you soon.
See you all soon, guys. Take it easy. Thanks for tuning in.
Let's see what's on the radio.
Shine your light on me. Kill!
Oh! Gonorrhea ruining me.
Coming through the Matrix, it was like from the future or some shit.
No.
Hello, listeners. You are very welcome, as always, to this show. Tonight, with Halloween around the corner, the age-old question comes into play. Is there enough for our kids to do? Around this time of year, our kids seem to be getting into more and more trouble. The guards collecting bonfire wood, having their bangers taken off them. But we're going to ask a few people, is there enough for our kids to do? On line one, I have Jacinta, mother of seven, from Coolock. Hello, Jacinta. Welcome to the show.
How are you, Randy? It's very nice to be on the show tonight.
That's very nice to have you.
Yeah, there's nothing for the kids to do these days. Okay. Absolutely nothing for them to do. Like, they're going out of their minds with the boredom.
Now, when you say that there's nothing for them to do, what exactly do you mean?
What else do you think I mean?
Oh, well,
nothing,
I'm sorry.
There's nothing. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, I do have to go up the stairs, right? Mm-hmm. My youngest is 14.
Oh.
And, I do be going up the stairs and I'd say to him, Braxton, you have to go out and do something. And he's like, Ma, there's nothing to do.
Oh, right.
Do you know what I mean, Ma? You're bro. And I'd be saying, get off that PlayStation 5, first things first, right?
Got to
throw your
games.
Canada Goose jacket on you, because it's fucking freezing outside. Mm-hmm. Tie up them Balenciagas and get out and do something. And he's like, Ma, Ma, there's nothing to do. There's only the Leisureplex and the Omni and that.
Yeah.
The shopping centres. I mean, there's only so much, hanging around Tesco that you can do.
Right.
Randy, do you know what I mean? They're not out of their heads with the boredom, so I don't blame them smashing up the cars and stuff.
But hold on, that seems a little bit excessive. Smashing up Garda cars. I don't think you can blame boredom. Smashing up a Garda car. Anyway, look, I've got Paul on line two. He's from Finglas. Hey, Paul, how are you doing? What do you think of what they said there? The lads are getting so bored that they're smashing up Garda cars.
That's
a bit excessive.
Load of bollocks. If you
excuse
ask
me.
She sounds like she'd want to get off a hole and look after off.
Yeah, just simply
look
after him.
I can look after my child.
Wild around the place.
Doesn't run wild around the place.
Thing, right, that was my young flat.
What do you mean?
Where'd she say she's from, actually?
Maybe she said.
What's to you? I don't know about car part of the thingless as well before.
Yeah.
I'm a kid, but I'm like.
Yeah, you did, didn't you? Yeah.
Yeah, I did.
We better get off this line because that's my young man that's running around. So, disregard everything we said before there. The show, Randy.
I think, look, the way things are going there, I think what we'll do is we'll cut to a break. I'm very sorry about that there. Very sorry.